Hello and welcome to OT Over Easy. My name is Becca and today we are going to be reviewing the development of pediatric hand motor skills. We are going to break these skills down into three major categories. One is manipulation of a larger object, one is manipulation of smaller objects, and one will be manipulation of a pen or pencil, so writing skills. I will be providing a timeline of the general ages that these skills start to develop, but I think the more important piece is knowing sort of what order they develop rather than assigning each skill to a specific age. This will probably be a fairly quick one, so without further ado, let's crack on. I'm just noticing all the trash my husband has on his desk in the background of my shot here. Anyway, let's talk about large object development first. The development of gross grasp essentially is just moving from using primarily the ulnar side of the hand, gradually working your way towards the radial side of the hand. Babies are born with a grasping reflex, right? You place an object in a baby's hand and the fingers will reflexively wrap around that object. So that is present from birth. But the first sort of intentional grasp that we get to see, a grasp that isn't reflexive, will start to emerge around 4 months of age, and it is going to be what we refer to as a crude or an ulnar palmar grasp. This is a grasp that uses the palm and the ulnar side of the hand. So essentially they're going to be picking up objects sort of like this, where the object is held firmly in the palm, pressed into the palm with the fingers, primarily on the ulnar side. The thumb is most definitely not going to be wrapped around that object anyway. It's going to be just kind of hanging out to the side here. But the primary feature of that ulnar palmar grasp is that it is in the ulnar side of the hand with the object pressed up into the palm. This is the first kind of grasp you're going to see. The next progression of this skill is going to be a palmar grasp. So instead of ulnar palmar, it is just palmar, which means that the object is going to be a little bit more centralized into that palm. So like I was saying earlier, the object, as skills develop, is going to start migrating towards the radial side of the hand. So we started over here in the ulnar, now we're in the palmar grasp. Now actually the way that I grabbed this instinctively is not quite correct. I wrapped my thumb around it for palmar grasp. Again, that thumb is probably not going to be involved yet. It's going to be back there with the rest of the fingers, maybe on the side, but not really a participant yet. This is the palmar grasp is going to be mostly the fingers pressing that object into the palm. Radial palmar grasp, which is where we're going next, now is when you're gonna see that thumb start to get a little bit more involved. So rather than the object being center in the palm, now it might be a little bit more with the thumb, the index, and the long finger that are primarily our graspers. Now that thumb is going to be more involved. It's going to start wrapping around that object and being an active participant a little bit more. This grasp is still a radial palmar grasp because even though it is on the radial side of the hand, that object is still pretty firmly pressed against the palm. Those fingers and maybe the thumb now are pushing it into the hand. That palmar aspect is what differentiates it from our next step, which is a radial digital grasp, which means that that object now is going to come away from the palm and we can hold it with our radial digits. So if we review that whole development again, the first stage is going to be that ulnar palmar grasp or a crude grasp. Then it's going to be a palmar grasp, then radial palmar grasp with that thumb starting to become a little bit more involved now. And then finally, that object is going to come out of the palm, be supported more independently by just the fingers in a radial digital grasp. That's it for large objects, so let's talk about smaller objects next. In the grand scheme of things, the general pattern looks very similar to the larger objects. Again, that smaller object is going to be transitioning from more of the center of the palm towards the radial side of the hand, and then progressively more and more out towards the tips of the fingers. The first kind of grasp we're going to see is what we call a rake grasp. This is a grasp where essentially the fingers are not articulating particularly well yet, but they're starting to kind of fold in towards the palm like this to pick something up. Next, this is going to transition into an inferior scissors grasp, which looks pretty similar to the rake grasp, but now those fingers are becoming a little bit more articulate, while that thumb is still not fully involved, we are kind of pushing that object a little bit more radially and those fingers are bending a little bit more effectively to get a hold of something. Next is going to be the scissors grasp or a lateral pinch. It's called lateral pinch because that thumb is coming from the lateral side to push against the hand. It is also called a scissors grasp because it's very similar to the motion you use when you are closing a pair of scissors. So again, that object is getting more and more radial. Now we're really kind of grasping it on this side of the hand. So that inferior scissors grasp is kind of like a loose, not so good form version of this. And then as you develop into the scissors grasp, also known as the lateral pinch, that's when it's really truly getting to the side of that hand and that thumb is really being a bit more effective. So now that we're on the radial side of the hand, now we're going to start moving out towards the tips of those fingers. So the first kind of step is what we call an inferior pincer. A pincer grasp would be using the tip of the thumb pushing against the tip of the index finger. So inferior pincer that comes before that is almost that motion, but the fingers are gonna be a little bit more flat. There's gonna be more surface area of contact between the fingers themselves and the object. So this here is our inferior pincer grasp. That is going to progress into the pincer grasp where there's not as much surface area contact. Now we're a little bit more just on the pads of the index finger and the thumb. And then our final step is just refining that even a little bit further to a fine pincer grasp where you're using not even the whole pads anymore, it's just the very, very tips of the fingers. And this is going to be the important grasp for now starting to get into really, really small objects. For adults, we think about pill management. For children, this might be getting a hold of buttons, pulling open food packaging, those more delicate fine motor tasks. So again, you see that radial and then digital progression of that object. We start with the rake grasp where we're kind of just generally bringing things into the palm with the fingers. Then it's going to be that inferior scissors grasp where the fingers are getting a little bit more articulate. And they're bringing that object a little bit more towards that radial side of the hand. And then it's that true lateral pinch or that scissors grasp. And from there, we're going inferior pincer, pincer, fine pincer. In some texts, you might also see this referred to as a meat pincer. Now, all of the skills that we have talked about so far are going to develop before we start developing our writing utensil skills. So let's go ahead and look at these together on a timeline before we talk about handwriting. All right, so here's our timeline that we're generally looking at. We are going to start developing grasp of larger objects before we start developing smaller objects. So again, our larger objects around 4 months of age, we're going to be starting with that ulnar palmar grasp. Then at about 5 months, you're going to have that palmar grasp. 1 month more, we're coming into that radial palmar grasp. Now, as we get into that radial palmar grasp, that's that same time that we're going to start seeing that rake grasp happening, right? Remember, radial palmar grasp is where, for the larger objects, we are starting to use that thumb a little bit more. So after we get that radial palmar grasp going, we are going to start developing that inferior scissors grasp. So now with those smaller objects, we're pulling it in towards that thumb a little bit more. And then around this 8 months of age is when we're really mastering our thumb a little bit more. So we're getting that scissors grasp or that lateral pinch with the small object. At the same time, we're developing that radial digital grasp as well. So your large object development is going to be just a little bit ahead of your small object development. But they match up grossly with how you are learning to use that radial side of your hand. So far everything has been progressing in 1 month increments, give or take. So we're gonna add 1 month more, and that's when we're going from that lateral pinch into that inferior pincer. One more month, we're at 10 months now, is when we're getting into the pincer as opposed to the inferior pincer. 10 months is pincer. And then around 1 year of age is when you're going to start seeing that neat pincer or fine pincer motion. So everything here happens all within about the first year of age. And then we're going to start developing our writing grasps. So somewhere roughly between the ages of 1 and 2 years old, you are going to start developing palmar supinate grasp. So let's break that down. Palmar indicates that the utensil is going to be held within the palm, and supinate means that the forearm is supinated. So that is going to look something like this. So pronated would be something like that. Supinated is going to look like this. This is the first writing utensil grasp. Palmar, supinate. Then as we get into 2 to 3 years of age, we're going to start developing a digital pronate grasp. So just like our large and small object development up here, palmar indicates in the palm, digital indicates with the fingertips. So digital, we're holding with the fingertips now. And pronate means that we are rotating that forearm. We're no longer supinate. Now we are palm down, right? So that digital pronate grasp is going to look something like this. Next, as we get past 3 years, now we're getting into 3.5, 4 years, we are going to start developing static tripod grasp. So tripod, right now, with the digital pronate grasp, I've kind of got all of my fingers on there. Static tripod, I'm going to be dropping and going into a 3-finger use. That's my tripod. Now you may see a quadruped grasp. That's just going to be using 4 fingers instead of 3. Neither is necessarily wrong or right or better. It's just sort of differences person to person on how they hold a pen or a pencil. But your static tripod or quadruped grasp is going to look something like this. It is called static because a lot of that motion is going to come from the wrist and above. You're not really going to be bending the fingers at all. The fingers are static in that tripod or quadruped position. So that is going to look something like this. Then as we start really mastering writing in that 4.5 to 6 years window, that is when it's going to develop from a static tripod into a dynamic tripod or a dynamic quadruped. Again, the difference, tripod 3, quadruped 4, but either way, the static was like this, the dynamic is like this. So dynamic is when those fingers and the thumb are actually going to start articulating more. So the wrist and the forearm are going to move much less, and those fingers are going to be far more active. So there is our full hand motor skills development timeline.
And that's it for pediatric grasp development. This was a topic that was requested in my comments section, so if you have something you'd like to see me cover, make sure to drop it down below. Feel free to leave any questions you have as well, and I'll do my best to clarify. But otherwise, I hope this makes understanding pediatric development a little more easy. Happy studying!